Dear students, today let's have a discussion on magnetic field and its properties. First of all, let us know what is a magnetic field. For example, if you take a magnet, it can attract the neighboring iron pieces. If this pin is kept near to this magnet, it is attracted by this one. As this pin is moved away, its influence becomes less on this pin. After crossing a certain region, its influence becomes zero. That's why the space, the region around this given magnet after which its influence is felt is called magnetic field. The space around the magnet within which its influence can be experienced is called magnetic field. Now, for understanding the effects of magnet or magnetism, the discussion of magnetic lines of force is very, very important. Hence, they introduced magnetic lines of force. What are magnetic lines of force? These are not actually visible, but the study of the lines of force in a magnetic field gives better information in understanding the concept. That's why, what are magnetic lines of force? Let's do one thing. Take a magnet. What you want to do now? You want to study how the field is existing around this one. Means uniformly, non-uniformly, everywhere the magnitude of field is same or different, you must know. Suppose if you take a magnet and you want to study the nature of the magnetic field around it. I took another magnet to study the nature of the field, but this magnet also produces field. So if you want to find the effect of the field due to this one here, that is influenced by this field also. That's why the pole strength of the magnet should be very less. Consider isolated north pole, isolated south pole. Actually, they do not exist. For explanation purpose, we took like this. So I told you, for testing purpose, this unit north pole is selected. Keep the unit north pole here. Then the north pole is repelled by this already existing north pole. That's why it would travel along this line. Due to force of repulsion, it travels along this line. That's why this line is called line of force. Along this line, the force is acting due to this one on unit north pole. So this is a line of force. The same can be drawn everywhere here. Suppose if you take this unit north pole here, it will travel like this along this direction. If you take here, it would travel like this. So we can draw infinite number of lines of force around a given isolated pole. Same as in this case, take isolated south pole. Unit north pole is kept here in this field. Then it is attracted by this one because of its south pole, and our testing purpose, the pole is north pole. So it is attracted by this one. So it travels like this. This arrow head indicates direction along which this pole is moving, along straight line here. But if it is kept here, it travels like this. here like this. Like this you can draw lines of force due to isolated south pole. You must understand what is the nature of lines of force here. Is the spacing between the lines, though these are straight lines, is the spacing between this one, these two lines equal, same? No. As we move away from this pole, spacing is changing, increasing. Which one indicates field is decreasing? What does this mean? Relative closeness of lines of force in a magnetic field indicates the strength of the magnetic field. If the lines of force crowded together, the field is said to be strong. If the lines of force are far apart, the field is said to be weak. What do you understand from this one? Near to this pole, lines of force very closer to each other, field is high nearer to this pole. As we move away, the spacing is increasing, which indicates that field gradually decreases. As we move away from this pole, the strength of the magnetic field gradually decreases. Same as in this case. Now, what is the nature of lines of force? Diverging in nature, converging in nature. Okay. In this field, is the magnitude of field same? No. Because spacing is changing, magnitude of field is changing. What is the direction? Here the direction is upwards, downwards, left, right. So direction of field is also changing. Both magnitude and direction of field changes from point to point in this one also. Now, hence this field is said to be non-uniform. Now, if you take isolated similar poles separated by certain distance, if you take unit north pole, take here, it is repelled by this unit north pole, which is kept here, is repelled by this pole. Then it will try to move along straight line as shown in this one. But it is under influence of this one also. Hence, it will try to move like this. Here also, like this. Same as in this case. What do you understand from this one? The lines of force have a tendency of bending sideways. Like this they are bending, which indicates repulsion. Repulsion between these two like poles. If you take a bar magnet and if you consider unit north pole, keep the unit north pole at this end, at this pole, that is repelled by, this is repelled by this one, then it will try to travel like this, but it is under influence of this one also, that's why it bends and it tries to travel like this. Same when it is kept here, you can draw lines of force like this. One more thing must remember, these lines of force leave or enter the surface normally. You should not forget that one also. And if you keep the north pole here, it can be repelled by this pole in this manner. That can be attracted by this one in this manner. So lines of force are taken in which direction the unit north pole is trying to move? Along this direction. So direction is taken from north pole to south pole outside. But you can imagine the magnetic field inside also. Why? Because Weber molecules are arranged in regular manner. That's why the lines of force inside the magnet will be from south pole to north pole, outside from north pole to south pole. Hence these curves are called closed curves. Closed curves. Next, let us discuss the properties of magnetic lines of force. Just now I told you the magnetic lines of force are closed curves like this. I show everything. Outside direction of lines is from north pole to south pole, and inside direction of lines of force is from south pole to north pole. And one more thing, these lines leave or enter the surface. Observe, here they leave and they enter here, enter the surface of the magnet normally. Nature of lines of force already have shown, due to isolated north pole diverging in nature, due to isolated south pole converging in nature, due to two like poles tendency to expand sidewise, due to unlike poles tendency to contract. They contract like this, they contract lengthwise. So the imaginary lines in a magnetic field along which a unit north pole would tend to move if free to do so. So this is the definition of magnetic lines of force, explained very clearly. Now last and final, here check this one. I already told you, if I want to know the direction of field here, whatever the direction is given for this field line of force, that is the direction of field. Here the direction of field is like this, along this line of force. Here the direction of field is along the line of force. Because of its straight line, you can easily say the direction of what? Field. What about this, these curves? So you want to know, if you want to know the direction of field at this place, at this point, draw a tangent at that point. Or here you want to know, draw a tangent. The tangent drawn at a given point gives the direction of field at that point. Don't forget this. This is very, very important. That's why the tangent drawn at a point gives the direction of magnetic field at that point, in this case, in the case of curves. And one more thing, if you draw lines of force north pole, south pole like this, any two lines of force do not intersect. They do not intersect each other. Why? If they intersect here, at the point of intersection, you can draw two tangents for these two curves, which indicates at this point field has two directions, which is impossible. It is not possible. At the same point, field cannot exhibit two directions. So any two lines of force do not intersect each other. This is also important for IP session, and these are few important concepts related to magnetic lines of force. Now let us discuss the classification of magnetic fields. The magnetic field can be classified into two types: uniform magnetic field, non-uniform magnetic field. What does it mean? In this case, as I discussed in the previous session, lines are straight, but if you take the field here, it is towards left, it is towards right, upwards, downwards, direction is different. The spacing is different. I told you already, spacing is less, field is said to be more. Spacing is more, field is said to be less. Unequal spacing is given here. As we move away from the pole, the spacing between the lines increases. That one indicates the field decreases, strength of the field decreases. What do you understand from this one? In this field, here also, verify here, these are cows. Here, these are very crowded together, here far apart. Here field, strength of the field is less, here strength of the field is more. So magnitude of field is said to be less here, more here. Direction changes from point to point. Hence, in this field, we can say magnitude and direction of field, magnetic field changes in this region. If you observe carefully, spacing is same means field is constant in magnitude. Arrows are showing same direction, that indicates direction is same everywhere. So if the strength of the magnetic field is same at every point in a given magnetic field, then that field is said to be uniform. If the strength of the field is not same at different points of a given magnetic field in both magnitude and direction, then that field is said to be non-uniform. So what is the nature of lines of force? In the case of uniform magnetic field, definitely spacing between lines of force should be same to show magnitude of the field is same at every place. Similarly, arrows are showing from left to right. Hence, you can say in this field, both magnitude and direction of the field is same at every place. In our daily life, I already introduced a word, horseshoe magnet. This is the shape of this horseshoe magnet. This is North Pole, this is South Pole. If they have flat surfaces, if you keep unit North Pole nearer to North Pole, this North Pole that is repelled by this one is attracted by this one, that unit North Pole. Hence, it travels along straight line. That means you can imagine a uniform, this uniform magnetic field, equidistant parallel lines. These are equidistant parallel lines. This type of field can be imagined due to asymmetric field. Suppose Earth is a huge magnet. You must know that one. Earth is a huge magnet. Around the Earth, you can imagine magnetic field. But it is huge and you are living in a small region. In this field, you can take magnitude and direction of field is same at a given region. That's why you can draw equidistant parallel lines in the case of Earth's magnetic field in a given region. Whereas in the case of non-uniform magnetic field, nature of lines of force are straight lines with unequal spacing, or curves with unequal spacing. Like here, these are straight lines, but unequal spacing. As we move from North Pole, away from the North Pole, the spacing is changing. That's why here also. So this one indicates non-uniform magnetic field. Let us discuss about magnetic induction due to a bar magnet or isolated magnetic pole. Suppose this is isolated north pole of pole string M. It is north pole. It forms magnetic field around it. You want to know its magnetic induction at this point in this field due to this pole. Then imagine a test pole here. Test pole is nothing but infinitesimal north pole is called test pole. It is used only for understanding purpose. Imagine this is only actually hypothetical pole. Imagine this one, then it experiences a force of repulsion due to this pole. Say that is F. On which one this force is acting? On M0. On M0, units of pole strength, force is F. On one unit north pole, what is the force? Then what is the formula for force acting per unit north pole? F by M0. F by M0 is defined as magnetic induction. So you want to know the induction here, you must find force acting per unit north pole at that point. Hence it is defined like this. It is a vector quantity. How to know the direction of B bar? Suppose it is north pole, isolated north pole. You want to know the direction of B bar here. Generally, what is imagined? Hypothetical unit north pole. So what is the direction of force acting on this unit north pole due to this one? Away. Repulsion, because of repulsion. This is the direction of B bar. Force direction, only direction of B bar. So here, if you imagine hypothetical unit north pole, it is attracted by this existing south pole. This one gives the direction of B bar at this point. So this is the concept here. And one more thing, how to represent B as per as definition? Force acting per unit north pole, that's why F by M0. On M0 pole, pole strength, F force. One unit north pole, what is the force? F by M0. Like this, it is taken. Next one. Magnetic induction due to isolated pole. If I consider a pole of pole strength M, and you want to find magnetic induction at this point P, which is located in a distance of what? Small r in air. Then imagine a test pole, that is M0. Let us find force acting on this one. Let F be the force on M0 due to M, this existing pole. According to Coulomb's law, F is equal to mu naught by 4 pi M1 M2, that means M into M0 by R square. But as per the definition, B is equal to F by M0, force acting per unit north pole. Then B is equal to, if I substitute here, M0 get cancelled, mu naught by 4 pi M by R square. It is only magnitude of B bar. How to know the direction? Already I mentioned here. You can get the direction from these two diagrams. Let us discuss how to find magnetic induction due to a bar magnet. I can select different positions in the case of a bar magnet. This is called axial line. This is called equatorial line. Let me find, first of all, magnetic induction at a point P on the axial line, which is located at a distance of D from the center of the bar magnet. In the case of bar magnets, distance of P is taken from the center. As we have discussed earlier, if you take a magnetic pole and it is north pole, and the induction at this point P, B is equal to mu naught by 4 pi m by r square when this distance is r. And if it is north pole, the direction at this point, direction of B at this point is away from this pole. If it is south and this direction is taken towards given pole. Hence, so this formula is for only isolated pole. Now I am going to find due to bar magnet which has two poles, due to north pole, induction at point P, induction is nothing but B. I give a symbol, Bn is equal to mu naught by 4 pi m by r. R is distance of the point P from this pole, directly is not given. Total distance from of P from center is given, and we know this length L, because total length is 2L. So D minus L is now R, that's why D minus L whole square. This is only magnitude of B bar. How to know the direction here? What is the direction of this one due to this one? Due to this north pole, away. That's why I take here Bn. That is, what is the direction here? We must express in terms of bar magnet. So south pole to north pole, you can say in one manner, south to north pole, you can write in this manner. R, what is the direction of M bar? Like this, south pole to north pole. So Bn is along M bar, along M bar. Next, due to south pole, what is the induction at this point P due to this pole? Bs. This point P is at a distance of D plus L and mu naught by 4 pi m by D plus L whole square. And you know what the direction of Bs? Already told you, due to south pole towards this pole. This is pole, like this is the direction of Bs. That is, what is the direction? North to south. Or M bar direction is like this, no? So this is opposite to M bar. Opposite to M bar. That means these are opposite in direction. Magnitudes are not equal. Why? This pole, this point is nearer to this pole compared to this pole. Hence, what is the net magnetic induction? B on axial line is equal to Bn minus Bs, because which is greater? Bn is greater than Bs. Substitute here, mu naught by 4 pi m is common, mu naught by 4 pi is common, and m also. Now 1 by d minus l whole square minus 1 by d plus l whole square. Now d square minus l square whole square, here d plus l whole square minus d minus l whole square, you know, a plus b whole square minus a minus b whole square. So here mu naught by 4 pi m into 4 dl by d square minus l square whole square, that is equal to mu naught by 4 pi, verify here, 2 into 2l, I will split this one, 2l into 2, m into 2l is capital M, capital M formula is small m into 2l, that's why I can write here 2 already there, m into 2l is capital M into d is now taken by d square minus l square whole square. So this is the formula for the magnitude of net magnetic induction on the axial line of a bar magnet. Now what is the direction, you know, which value is greater, bn or bs? Bn. So the net value will be in the same direction as greater value, so that is bn. What is bn direction? Here you can say south pole to north pole, like this, or along m bar. So the direction is from south pole to north pole. In the case of this one, on equatorial line, on this line, on this line, consider a point P which is located at a distance of d from the center. Let us find induction at this point P due to north pole first. Due to north pole, join this one, and what is the direction of B at this point P due to this north pole? Away. So it is Bn. What is magnitude of that Bn? It is isolated pole, same mu naught by 4 pi m by r square. You know, this is L, this is d, and this one is root over d square plus l square. Hence this distance square, so we get here d square plus l square only. Now it is given direction away from north pole, away from this north pole, due to south pole, this pole at this point P. What is the induction? Bs. Mu naught by 4 pi m by this distance also, same as this one, say d square plus l square. Now it is towards south pole, say this, this is the direction of Bs. If you observe carefully, these two are equivalent magnitude, but directions are different, magnitudes are same. Then I will find the resultant based on parallelogram law of vectors. I will draw like this, a line parallel to this vector, a line parallel to this vector. This diagonal gives resultant, definitely should be parallel to this one, because this value and this value are equal. and this is our net induction on equatorial line. That's what BE. This is BN. This is BS. If you consider this triangle and this triangle, these two triangles are similar, then the ratio of corresponding sides are equal. Hence, I will find resultant magnetic induction. What is the corresponding side to this one? In this case, 2L. So, BE by 2L is equal to, what is the corresponding side to this one in this triangle? This side, that is root over DE square plus L square. Now, BN by root over D square plus L square. That implies, what do you want? BE. What is BN? This one. So, mu naught by 4 pi M by D square plus L square into 2L. Remaining part, this one. D square plus L square power 1 by 2. Therefore, BE is equal to mu naught by 4 pi. What is M into 2L? It's magnetic moment of this bar magnet by D square plus L square power 3 by 2. What's the direction of this one? Do you know? This is the direction. In which direction is oriented? From north pole to south pole, means parallel to this magnet, north pole to south pole, or this is the direction of M bar, opposite to M bar. So direction can be expressed from north to south pole parallel to bar magnet. Or opposite to M bar at that point. When this bar magnet is not long one, it is short one like this, then how to express these two formulae, I will discuss. That means, if you take a small bar magnet, and this is a distance d, compared to this L, d is very larger, L is very smaller. Hence, L is very smaller, L square becomes very smaller, that's why this L square can be neglected in this case. So, for short bar magnets, I consider L is very much lesser than D. Substitute here, then BA means on axial line for short bar magnet. What is the answer? L square is neglected. D square whole square, that is D power 4. This D power 4, in D power 4 1 D get cancelled. So mu naught by 4 pi 2m by D cube. 2m by D cube, where the D is the distance of the point from the center of the bar magnet only. So in the case of BE, in this case, what do you understand? L square is neglected. Then D square power 3 by 2. 2 2 get cancelled. D cube is left. So mu naught by 4 pi capital M by D cube. Direction is same as in this case, long bar magnet. Don't forget about this one. if these are useful in solving some numericals. This is on axial line, this is on equatorial line. What? Magnetic induction due to bar magnet at two different places. This is another case. Other than axial line or equatorial line, at any other point, take this point is located at a distance of D from this center. Okay, but it is derived by considering this bar magnet is short bar magnet. This is M bar. This M bar can be resolved into, because it is a vector, two components. One component is along this line, the line joining the center and the point P. So another component perpendicular to this one, you know, they will give you this angle. What is the component of M bar along this line? Say M cos theta, and it is M sin theta. Hence, I took this magnet is short bar magnet, and this point seems to be on the axial line of this dipole moment, and this point seems to be on the equatorial line of this dipole moment. Hence, for short dipoles or magnets, for axial line, this is the formula. So if you apply here, induction at point P due to this component, I take B1. It is on the axial line of this dipole momentum, that's why I will take this one. And in the place of M, I will take M cos theta. So answer is mu naught by 4 pi 2 M cos theta by distance is D. DQ. And induction due to this dipole moment at this point P. This point P seems to be on the equatorial line of what? M sin theta. Hence, this formula is selected. Mu naught by 4 pi. What is here? M. What is this dipole moment here? M sin theta. So, M sin theta by DQ. What is the direction of B1? What is the direction of BA? And the direction of M bar. So, this is the direction of M bar, magnetic moment. So, I take the direction B1 like this. What is the direction of BE? Opposite to M bar. What is the M bar of this one? This is the direction. Opposite to this one means like this must take. It is B2. Now draw a parallelogram to find the resultant. I join these two points to which forms diagonal. This one gives resultant, new one. Resultant. So what is resultant? At this point P. These are mutually perpendicular to each other. Hence, root 2 over B1 square plus B2 square, which is in turn root 2 over, I will take mu naught by 4 pi M by D cube as common. So mu naught by 4 pi capital M by D cube and root 2 over 2 cos theta whole square, that is 4 cos square theta plus here remaining part sin theta, so sin square theta. That implies B net is equal to, verify, mu naught by 4 pi M by D cube After simplification, I can write in 4 cos square theta, I separate 1 cos square theta. 1 cos square theta plus 1 sin square theta becomes 1. So 1 plus the remaining part is what? 3 cos square theta. This is a formula to find net magnetic induction at this point P. But this one gives only magnitude. But what is the direction? Direction of this one, this is B net. This is B net. It is expressed in terms of this angle. Consider this angle is alpha. Tan alpha is equal to opposite side, that is B2. This is B2, that's why it is also B2. B2 by, this is adjacent side. This is B1. B1. What is B2? This one. What is B1? This one. If you substitute the two values, which values get cancelled? Mu naught by 4 pi, mu naught by 4 pi. M by dq, m by dq. For the remaining part, in this one, B2, sin theta. What is left in this case? 2 cos theta. Therefore, tan alpha is equal to tan theta by 2. This is a way to find angle made by net B at this point P with B1. So this is one important concept. Have nice grip on this area, because so many numericals can be solved by using this concept.